we are in section 7 now. Section 7 talks about supply. See, in charging section, majority words we have understood. You must be remembering, in section 9 the word was all intrastate supply of goods and services or both. So we are done with definition of goods, we are done with definition of service. Definition of goods were given in clause section 2, clause 52, and clause 102 is for service, yes or no? But what you did not understand, what is the meaning of supply? Supply is the trigger point, you understand? If supply happens, then only GST is leviable, otherwise it is not leviable. So we call it taxable event. The legal phrase for this is, what is taxable event in customs, import of goods? Yes or no? What is taxable event in income tax, earning of income? Okay. What is taxable event in excise, manufacturing? Yes or no? What is taxable event in VAT, sale? Hello? So what is taxable event in GST, supply? It's not sale, it's supply. All right. And supply is much more wider term that you and me can understand. Is so big that it covers so many aspects. Okay, so let us understand what is there in supply. First of all, there are four subsection of section 7. There are four subsection. On my board you can see only three, because only three are in effect, fourth one is not in effect. Okay, and the subsection divides like this: subsection 1, subsection 1A, subsection 2, and subsection 3. Subsection 3 we have not written because it is not in effect. We are studying only what is in effect as of now. Out of these three subsections, as I told you, whenever we discuss in subsection, all right, subsection 1 is the core, all right. Subsection 1 is further divided into three clauses. So 71A, 71B, and section 71C. So this is how this image should be there in your mind. Section 7 is divided into three main subsection: section 71, section 71A, section 72. Section 7 1 is further divided into three clauses: 71A, 71B, and 71C. Now I'm going to teach you everything from 71A, but you need to remember only this red ink word. So for the examination is concerned, okay, for examination only these two words are important. Balance, I'm going to teach you everything from this. All right. So supply includes, first of all, this word is very important. Okay, they did not say supply means. There is a difference between supply means and supply includes. When I say supply means, that means government have given you exhaustive list. Only this is supply, and only if this happens, then only it will be taxable under GST. Otherwise, it is not taxable. But here they are not saying supply means. Here they are saying supply includes. Little casual, okay. This is also supply, that is also supply, that is also supply. Something new also will be supply, because we are just telling you this is how supply should be understood. Hello? So supply includes, the definition is inclusive definition, not exhaustive definition. Am I clear? Government have written open-ended definition. What is the purpose of writing open-ended definition? Because this law is new law, and they don't want to be foolish by writing exhaustive law. Because if they write exhaustive law, people will try to prove, okay, this is not covered in supply, so there is no tax on that activity. Hello? Certain activity, they may frame that it is not there in supply, and therefore it is not taxable. Right now I cannot do that, because they will say, sir, this is not definition of supply, this is just the illustrative definition. Okay, reasonably supply should be understood like this. Am I clear? Yeah. So section 7.1 clause A talks about supply includes all form of supply. Look at the word supply includes all. You just talk about what form it can be supplied. These are the goods, in what form I can supply. It includes all form of supply. They did not stop there only. They said it includes all form of supply of what? What is taxable in GST? Of goods or service or both. Goods, service or both, we have already understood. So I'm not going into that. Such as, they are giving you now example of different types of supply. Okay, such as, the basic form of supply that happens in industry is sale. Yes or no? The basic form by which goods can be supplied by one person to another is sale. Yes or no? I can sell these markers to you. So that is supply. Not only this, transfer. Now transfer is a word that you will understand better in capital gain chapter, direct tax. Okay. Transfer have one or two pages definition separately. Transfer of capital asset. Okay. So transfer is much more bigger word than sale. Like gift. Hello. Gift is also transfer. Inheritance. That is also a transfer. It's not sale, but it is transfer. So that you will understand in your capital gain chapter. Supply includes sale, transfer, barter. You understand barter system?
Yes.
Alright. and exchange. Okay, so first word was sale, transfer, barter, exchange. Try to remember word by word. Sale, transfer, barter, exchange. Sale, transfer, general word. Barter and exchange. What is the difference between barter and exchange is this. If I give you jewelry and you give me electronics. I give you jewelry and you give me electronic, then it is barter. Are you getting this?
Yes.
Exchange means I give you old car and in exchange I bought
new car.
So in exchange commodity is same. In barter commodities are there, but there are different commodities. Am I clear? Okay. Sale, transfer, barter, exchange. Not only that, lease. Sometime I don't sell goods, I will give it in on lease. Okay. Lease, rental. See, lease is usually long term, rental is usually short term. They have covered both word. So sale, transfer, barter, exchange, lease, rental, license. You understand, certain goods are given on license basis. Yes or no? Intellectual property right, usually they give it on license basis. Software they give it on license basis. Okay, license or disposal. Disposal means even if I take it and sell it to the scrap dealer. Hello? Take it and I did not sell it, I dispose of. You understand? Hello? Dispose means khatam kar dena, finish it off. Okay, even that is supply. And is it only part of supply? Is it only supply? Only these are the words of supply? No, supply includes. Includes means this is also supply, this is also supply, this is also supply. And if you bring certain new word like this, that will also be
supply.
Because they are not writing this is the only supply, these are just illustrative words such as. Hello? So what up to here, can you remember with me? All form of supply of goods, service or both such as sale, transfer, barter, exchange, lease, rental, license and disposal made or agreed to be made. Made or agreed to be made for a consideration by a person in the course or furtherance of business. Again, all form of supply of goods, service or both such as sale, transfer, barter, exchange, lease, rental, license, disposal made or agreed to be made for a consideration by a person in the course or furtherance of business. Am I clear? Very good. Of business. So this is the meaning of supply. Bare meaning of supply. Now let us try to understand what are the factors of supply. When you got up in morning, your mom made some dosa for you. Is it a supply? She made dosa and she gave you. And you ate that dosa and you came here. Is it a supply?
No.
Because there is no consideration. And secondly, it is not her business. If you go to this restaurant Shiv Sagar and you order dosa there, that is supply. Why? That is in course of business. And secondly, there will be consideration. So therefore your mama did not charge you GST and this Shiv Sagar will charge you GST. Are you getting this different? Okay, so this is one example I wanted to give you. You sold your this old books to this scrap dealer. There is a scrap dealer next to our classes. Yes or no? All right. So you sold your old books to this scrap dealer. Will there be consideration?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. We are not throwing it. There will be consideration. But is it your business to sell scrap?
No.
All right. What if we as an institution, we sold our books? We as an institution, we also have a lot of books now. So we sold that. Last year books are not useful. So we sold it off.
Business.
This is business. This is not business, but sir, it is not your business to sell books. Your business is to conduct classes, but it is furtherance of
business.
Furtherance of business. Yes or no? All right. Air India. What is the business of Air India? Passenger transportation by air. Passenger transportation by air. That is the business of Air India. Yes or no? But if you go to Air India flight, they also serve you meals, food and all. Yes or no? Now serving meals is not their business, but it is furtherance of business. Yes or no? So only passenger transportation is not taxable for them. Even food supply is also taxable. Although it is not their business, but it is furtherance to their business. You understand? In relation to their business. Am I clear? Okay. Selling this laptop is not my business. because I use this laptop to run my business. Okay, so if I sold this laptop, if I transfer this laptop, will there be GST or no? This is the question I'm asking you. Am I liable to pay GST if I'm selling this laptop to you? Yes, it will be, because this is a business asset. This is a business asset. If I sell it to you, it will become supply, because it is not my business to sell laptop, but it is a business asset, so it comes under furtherance of business. So it is not only in the course of business. There are two words: in the course or furtherance of business. Okay, so furtherance of business has little wider scope than business. Okay, logic I will explain now. Here you will understand logic why it is like I'm saying like this. So secondly, if I teach, please understand, if I teach you and then take consideration from you, should I charge GST? Right now I'm teaching you guys. Okay, I'll take fee as well as GST. Are you getting this?
Yes.
As the institution, I'm teaching you. Can I take fees and GST from you?
Yes.
Why? Because is it a supply?
Yes.
My activity. Think like this. No. Is it supply?
Yes.
Why? It is my business to teach. And there is a
consideration.
You know? So I will take GST from you. You are teaching to your friend. You know, in breaks and all, you people teach to each other.
Yes.
Did you take GST from each other?
No.
Two reasons.
No
consideration and no bill. Imagine your friend is saying, okay, I will teach you, but I need 200 rupees, or I need dairy milk, or I need Chinese. So consideration is there, but still you will not take GST. Why? Because it is not your business to teach. Am I clear? So I did not say only consideration is important. No. I did not say only business is important. I said business plus consideration. Both are important. Okay, business plus consideration, both are important. Tomorrow if I take free seminar on GST, hello, for some, you know, Mumbai, some Western Mumbai Trade Association is there and they want some enlightenment on GST. They called me, sir, can you speak for 2-3 hours on GST, how GST should be understood by the business class, just as a free, like, and they will give me one shawl and, you know, just like memento, not money. It is not money related activity. Okay, should I charge GST from them? It's my business to take lecture, but I'm not taking any consideration. So what I'm saying, if one of the component is missing, either business or consideration, then it is not a supply. So particular activity to become supply, you need to have two factors, two core words. It has to be in the course of business, or and there should be a consideration. So B plus C, am I clear? BC hai, to supply hai. BC में का B नहीं है या C नहीं है तो supply नहीं है. As per 7(1)A, then I will teach you extension to those clauses. Am I clear?
Yes.
Sure, can I go ahead up to here? It's clear? Pakka crystal clear?
Yes.
Now GST should be paid according to me when there is a supply. Yes or no? This is what I'm trying to understand.
Yes.
If I supply these goods to you, then I should be liable to pay GST. Are you getting this?
Yes.
I supplied these goods or services to you, then only I should be liable to pay GST. We are just talking. In future, I will supply you goods. 1 month later, I will supply you goods. Or when you become CMA finalist, I will teach you taxation. You ask me this question today, sir, if you pass in CMA Inter, will you teach us taxation in CMA final? I said, yes, I will teach. Is it my business to teach?
Yes.
Yes. Will I charge consideration?
Yes.
Yes. Should I pay tax today?
No.
Who told you that? Look at the language.
Made
or agreed to be made. So did I made supply? No, I did not made supply. I'll make supply when you become CMA finalist. But I got agreed to make supply. Yes or no? So what happened here now? Why this language is written? This is very worst, no? This is disastrous language, no? See, you take tax when there is a supply. I understand completely. You are taking tax even without supply. Just I got agreed to make supply. Dilip sir asked me next year, padhai available? Yes sir, I will teach next year also. So they are saying it is supply because supply is done, made or agreed to be made. So this language is written only for advances, only for agreed for made. So if I say, okay sir, I will teach here next year also, hello, but I need 2 lakh rupees now. for teaching next year, I'm taking advance money from him. Okay, then on that advance money also GST is chargeable. So this may come as a question, whether advance money is taxable or not taxable. Advance for supply is taxable or, see, consideration for supply is taxable. I'm asking, advance for supply is taxable or not taxable? Now there are two answers. Okay, advance for goods is not taxable and advance for service is taxable, because there is a notification which exempts advance for goods. Hello, as per law both taxable. From here it is, or from here it is clearly written, no, advance is taxable for both, but there is an exemption notification. In future I will teach exemption notification 66, exemption notification 66, which exempt advances of goods. That will come in future, we will talk in future. Advance taxable or not taxable as of now?
Taxable.
Advance. Why taxable? Because there are two words, made or agreed to be made. Am I clear with this? I don't want to go into detail now, it's enough. Okay. That means if it is not in the course of business, then it is not taxable. If activity is not in the course of business, then it is not taxable. But there is one exception in law, and that exception is written in 71B. 71B. 71B talks about importation of service. First observation you should understand, this is not about importation of goods, this is only about importation of service. 71A have three words, goods or service or both. 71B have only service, so this is only applicable to import of service, it is not applicable to import of goods. Am I clear? Because import of goods are taken care by Customs Act. Yes. Import of goods is taken care by Customs Act. We are concerned in GST only by importation of service. See, goods will come in bag or container or vessel. Service is not like that. No, service is intangible in nature. Therefore, custom authority cannot have control over import of service.
Yes.
Therefore, GST authorities are having control over importation of service. So you need to understand this. Importation of goods is covered by Custom Act and importation of service is covered by GST law. Am I clear? Importation of service for a consideration, that means one word is there, consideration is there. Yes or no? Consideration is there. So what is missing? C is there. Okay. Then what is missing? Whether or not in the course or furtherance of business. Whether or not in the course or furtherance of business. That means business hoga tabhi bhi chalega? Nahi hoga. Why it is written here? Because see, if business is also there and consideration is also there. I'm asking you, if business is also there and consideration, both words are there, will you travel to 71B? No, it will become supply as per 71A itself. Yes or no? We will travel to 71B only when it is without business but for a consideration. Without business but for a consideration. So what I say, in 71B, B nahi hai but C hai. 71A needs B as well as C. 71B doesn't have B but needs C. Okay. Likewise, here I will say 71C. 71C doesn't have C but needs B. Okay. So 71A have BC. 71B have C. 71C have B. A, BC, C, B. All right. That means if there is no B as well as no C. That means B is also missing, C is also missing, both are missing. For sure, for 100% sure, it is not supply, it is not taxable. 100% sure, your friend came to your house and he stayed there with you guys. You made a food for him. Is it a business?
No.
For a consideration?
No.
Both are not there. Will you take GST from him?
No.
No, because it is not a supply. Second day he woke up. He wanted to go directly to office or some place. And he was not having clothes to change. So what will you do as a friend? You gave your own clothes to him. Give. And you know that by looking at that friend's behavior, it will never come back. So it's not borrowing of clothes, it's transfer of clothes. Yes or no? Alright? Will you charge GST?
No.
Why? selling of cloth is not your business, at the same time you did not charge any consideration. So what I am trying to say, if B and C both are missing, 100% sure it is not taxable under GST. To tax under GST, 99% transaction, you need both business as well as consideration. Only one transaction, only one transaction where business is not required, that is importation of service. Are you getting this? So there is one architect in Dubai, very famous architect in Dubai. What is that building name? Burj Khalifa, right?
Yes.
So that Burj Khalifa building is created by that architect. I wanted my 2 BHK flat in village should be designed by him. Hello? Yes. I'll give you two examples. I want my CA firm office and one house to be designed by him. If I import his service for designing my office, it is covered by 71A.
Yes.
How? He will charge consideration and that is in the course of business. Okay. Secondly, I called his services for designing my personal house. Hello? So one thing is for sure, it is not in the course of
business.
It is not in the course of business, but it is in course of it is importation of service for a consideration. So consideration is there. Am I clear?
Yes.
Yeah. So this is 71B. 71C is more surprising than 71A and B. 71C, certain activities, only certain activities, because this is the deemed charging section. Okay. Somewhere you can write, this is the deemed supply. This is not actual supply. This is deemed supply. Okay, with pencil and all, you can write here somewhere. This is not actual supply. This is deemed supply. Deemed to be supply. Okay. What is deemed to be supply? In reality, it may not look like a supply, but it is a supply. By law, it is a supply. By force of law, it is supply. Am I clear? Okay. Whenever I use word deemed means I usually say like this. What is. What isn't is, what isn't is, if loss is, okay. Jo hai, wo hai, jo nahi hai, wo nahi hai, aur jo nahi hai, wo hai, if loss is. So, ye supply nahi hai, but hai, maan lo, because it is written in law, that is the deeming fiction of law. Law have power to deem something which is not there, but it is there. Okay, so this is not a supply in ordinary course of business with a normal common sense. This is not a supply, but law is asking us to deem it as a supply. So do we have choice?
No.
And why the hell law is deeming it as a supply? Logic I will explain. But law wanted to take tax on these activities. Now whenever law put deeming fiction, do you understand properties of this rubber? Have you ever played that game with your friend? You are hitting that guy with a rubber. Yes or no? Alright, whenever you are hitting that guy with a rubber, someday it happens, in case of excitement, you wanted to hit him very hard, okay, you stretch that rubber beyond its capacity and it breaks from here.
Yes.
And instead of hitting him, your own karma operates and you punish yourself. Yes or no?
Yes.
Alright, so what is the properties of rubber? It's stretchable. Properties of rubber is stretchable, but you cannot stretch it beyond its capacity. Hello? You can stretch it, stretchable commodity, but you cannot stretch it beyond its capacity. So what is the power of deeming fiction? Deeming fiction is bringing your charge. It's like bringing charge from there here to cover certain activities, but you cannot bring charge beyond its purpose. So it has to be for limited activities. Otherwise, what is the point of having B and C? No, if all other activity, even without consideration, here we are having activities without
consideration.
If even without consideration activity can become supply, hello, even without consideration activity can become supply, then why the hell you are writing 71A? You have written 71A and by saying, oh, consideration should be there, consideration should be there, consideration should be there. 100 of times you said consideration should be there. And then in some other clause you are going and saying, okay, supply can be even without consideration. Then 71C can directly kill 71A and then nobody will give any importance to 71A, isn't it?
Yes.
Hello? And therefore, 71C cannot have unlimited access. 71C should have only limited access. For limited purpose, because it is not charging section. Charging is here. This is deemed charging section, and therefore law has created schedule 1. Hello, therefore law has created Schedule 1. Schedule 1 have 4 paragraphs, only 4 activities. Hello, so there are, in this world, there are only 4 activities which can be called as a supply without consideration. There are only 4 activities in this world which can be called as a supply even without consideration, and those activities are written in Schedule 1. Let me tell you, in whole GST Act, CGST Act, there are 3 schedules. How many schedules?
3.
And all three schedules are having origin in Section 7.1. Section 7. Hello?
Yes.
There are only 3 schedules in GST law.
Yes.
Okay? And all 3 schedules are on my board. Schedule 1, Schedule 2, and Schedule
3.
Hello? And all these 3 schedules are important. Okay? So in sections, we don't have much to discuss. Section is almost over. Okay, but we have schedules to discuss, and in schedules we need lot of discussion, and then I will be teaching you schedules from your book, directly from your module. Yes or no? Alright, so right now you need to keep things in mind. Okay, 3 things in mind you need to remember now. 7.1 is divided into 3 clauses, 7.1a, 7.1b and 7.1c. 7.1a demands 2 words, business and consideration. 7.1b says import of service, consideration is required, but it can be in the course of business or not in course of business. Am I clear? So C is there, but B is missing. In 7.1b, B is missing, C is there. Yes or no? And how to remember in 7.1c? 7.1c, C is missing, B has to be there. Because if B and C both are not there, one thing is for sure, it is not be, it cannot be considered as supply, and it will never become taxable. So there are only 4 situations. You understand permutation and combination? So B and C both are there. Which clause is applicable? In exam you saw example, and then they have asked you certain question where you can see, okay, it is business and consider, both words are there.
7.1a.
Then in exam you saw importation of service for personal purpose. That means business is not there, but consideration is there.
7.1b.
Okay. Then you saw certain activity where consideration is not there. One example, I donated this laptop, I wanted new laptop, and I donated this old laptop to some charitable institution. So I donated. Donation means, you understand, no?
Yes.
Donation means I'm just donating for good faith. Is it supply or not a supply? Is it a supply or not a supply? It is a deemed supply. It is deemed supply. Why? Because this is business asset. This is
business.
So I said business is there. Therefore only. If I donate my washing machine from my home,
no.
That's not a business asset. That's a personal asset. So business is not there and consideration is also not there.
Yes.
Then it is not supply. This is a business asset and now I donate it. So business is there, but
consideration
is missing, and it's one of the activity of mentioned in Schedule 4. And how many activities are there in Schedule 4? 4? Schedule 1? How many activities we have in Schedule 1? 4. Para 1, Para 2, Para 3, Para 4. 4 paras are there. Para 1, Para 2. Are you getting this? In Schedule 1, we have to discuss 4 para. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay. Only 4 activities. So what I'm trying to say, you need to remember 5 activities. 1 plus 4. 1 plus
4.
Only these are exceptional activities. Balance all activities need to have 2 components. Business and consideration. Am I clear? Only 5 activities are having exceptional nature. Balance all activities. In exam they will ask, you know, whether this activity is supply or not a supply. What will you remember? If there is a business in that activity and if there is a consideration, then only it is supply, otherwise it is not supply. Am I clear? One activity, importation of service for a consideration, business is not required, still it will be considered as supply. And there are 4 activities in Schedule 1 of Section 7.1c which are deemed to be supply. Am I clear?
Yes.
Pakka? Now you can see my charging section and you can see my supply section, both. They don't separate goods and service. Majority language you have written like this only, no? Goods or service or both. If it is only goods, we don't mind it. If it is only service, we don't mind it. Hello? Section 11 onwards. Section? In fact, section 10 onwards. Okay, we are discussing up to section 9. Almost we have already discussed up to section 9. Section 10 onwards, these two go separate. Which two? Goods are having this route and services are having this route. Although GST is a common law for both of them, no? For goods also, for supply of goods, which law is applicable now in India? GST. For service also which law is applicable?
GST.
That means for goods also GST is applicable, for service also GST is applicable. Certain people are selling only goods. So I sold this laptop. What activity?